Oh, they're coming.
Okay.
Look at the camera. There we go, that's good. Damn, it looks good, Tom. Look at the camera here down there.
Okay.
Thanks, I appreciate that. This is as much fun for me as it is for you. I love my screensaver. It brings me so much happiness in my screensaver having the pictures of you and Terry. It really does.
Oh, nice.
It's just really fun, you know. Really fun.
Now, do you think this is a big deal? They have the little corner pieces in there.
Oh.
And it looks like they have the grain going.
That doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. No? It's, yeah, just anything that fits in there, you know. Yeah. And, But doing something like this is difficult because these are so thick. Normally you don't have sticks that are that thick and they're wide.
Yeah.
So this is harder than like my Martin Mars will be, you know what I mean?
Really? Wow.
Because these are wider and bigger.
Yeah.
If they were small square stock, like quarter inch square stock, it'd be a lot easier, you know what I mean? But when it's this big, this is harder to do. So you're kind of learning on something that's more difficult, you know? I like your coffee.
It's very good.
That's corn. You know, at Sprouts, they got all different flavors, so you go there and you can grind it there or grind it at home. I used to grind it at home, but I grind it there.
Oh, okay.
But I like the corn. It's probably the biggest selling one.
Yeah, that's good.
From Hawaii, needless to say.
Mm-hmm. Good place.
Yeah. So.
I bet if I was paying attention, you know, this here and that, so if I make, I just cut wooden edge.
Yeah, well, flip it over. It will.
Well, I don't know if that came from there for sure or not, but it does seem
I see.
To fit.
Yeah, you'll find that. You just keep monkeying with it. And that's another thing that makes it difficult, because that thing's at an angle like this, so it's hard to know exactly what it is, so you got to kind of bring it up like you're doing right there, you know what I mean? And get it close and cut it a little bit long and then sand it, which is nice having a sander, you know what I mean? But you as you're doing all this stuff, you'll get more and more familiar with it and it'll be easier for you, you know? And by the time you get, you know, the elevator done, you'll have this technique down really well, which is going to serve you for every other model you build, you know? And those open structures are just kind of neat to look at. I mean, like you say, over on Bill's wing, using transparent covering, it looks so nice, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And like my Tiger 60, it's so nice to see it and see the pictures of it. Oh, thanks for taking some dynamite pictures. That's a float fly, too.
Oh, yeah.
of it in the water, that really makes me happy to see that, especially one the sun's reflecting in it, so it looks kind of nice. But build-up structure is something that everybody always admires, you know, all the builders there, because they know how much work it is.
I should have got a picture at that March Air Base. They had some they had models in there too, especially World War One, and some of them were like super detailed. The World War One planes, I mean, they had the cross bracing internal wiring, the cap strips on every.
Well, Lou Proctor made the World War I kits, and they were almost museum scale. You know, if you, I don't know if you, you're familiar with the name Bert Proctor, Well, his, you know, and Otto likes that a lot, like the antique he built. You saw that is a real Proctor kit. And it wasn't a real airplane, but it was done, the construction of that kit is exactly the same as the full-scale World War I airplanes were built. And so he was going to enter it in a antique flying or something like that. Some of the guys bitched, well, that's not a real airplane. Look, dummy, it may not be a real airplane, but the structure is exactly the way the full scale were built. Not the model, but the full scale. And so it's, but Lew Proctor's kits are were renowned, and still are, you know, and revered, you know, more so than even Ivan Pettigrew's planes, you know. Boy, I sure like that Albatross, that Grumman Albatross and that
PBM. Yeah, those are beautiful,
Oh, shit. If that Albatross was 100-inch wingspan, I would have ordered it immediately.
What size is it?
It's only like 72 or so.
Oh, you know? Still, it's not...
And, you know, like my Tiger is 72, and it doesn't look very impressive when it's out in the water, you know?
Yeah, but, small fast.
Huh?
They get small fast.
Boy, don't they ever. They look real big on the billing board. Then you get out there and you get out there on the flying field or on the water, and they get like especially RC gliders. You build an RC glider with an 8-foot wingspan. You think, man, this thing really is big. Get out there and put it in the air, and they get small real quick. You know what I mean?
Oh yeah, I've ordered some stuff for you.
It's only a 76-inch wingspan, but you know I'm still tempted. That's 76, and the PBM is 100. But the PBM's a damn foamy. But I'm still almost tempted to order that. I'm almost tempted to order both of them too, because they're only it's only $155 for both of them.
Jeez,
and that's nothing. I can do a little repair job, make that much money. So, and you got big feet. What size are your feet? 13s?
Oh, yeah.
God. Shit, you can water ski barefoot at times.
I tried, it didn't work well.
You gotta go faster.
Yeah. I did. I used to do a lot of water skiing out in Guam.
Did you really?
Oh, yeah.
No shit.
Yeah.
I'll be damned.
Well, I never, I mean, I could slalom, but we didn't have an actual slalom course set up. The single ski and everything.
Oh my, really? No shit? Good for you.
Those are the days I was, we were like, it was like water skiing almost every other day and scuba diving in between. I got all the way down, I was like 185 pounds or something.
This guy's coming as Tyson's former Marine and his pool player, and he worked for me a little bit. But he will again if I get a job to, or something he can help me with.
Oh, what's he doing here? What's he here for today?
Oh, he said he got a wetsuit needs to be sewn.
Oh, okay.
What's your son's name?
Kai.
Hi, Kai.
That's Mitch. Say what's up, Mitch.
How are you?
I'm Tom.
And that's Tom.
Flying buddy. How are you?
What's up, man? Good, how are you? Nice to meet you. Come on, Kai.
Yeah.
Buddy, how are
you? Good to see you. Good to see you. Kai, look what Tom's working on. Show him.
Oh, yeah.
Building an airplane.
So the zipper in the...
Look like.
See, once this goes, it's no longer waterproof and it's not worthless.
I hear that.
So, it's got. So yeah, Mr. Mitch down that here, one.
I wouldn't be able to build one like that.
What's going on? It's someone tried to half-ass fix
cool,
it.
We've
got to get it somewhat waterproof, you know?
Yeah.
And if you got that Teflon thread or something?
For sure. That's all I need.
That would be amazing.
Check this out, buddy. Look, they're building airplanes. You want to see?
You take them in that first bedroom to the left, show them all the planes are in there.
Okay.
Yeah, that's.
See, this is how they do it. You see all the plans? He reads those and then he puts together the big airplanes. You want to see the big airplanes?
The cool ones over there.
It's a boxer plane? Why? Because it's folded up like a box? Yeah, that's fine. I don't care where it. That's fine if it works. Huh, Papa?
Yeah.
See, we're tired of being cold.
You scuba dive or surfing?
Surf.
Oh, okay. Nice.
Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
Hi, Mr. Crampton, how are you? How late are you going to be at the ship? Okay, cool. If I can't come down this afternoon, I'll come down tomorrow. And I was in that at that marina, so I would you run over to your ship, and I've also I went aboard the ship, and then I went up up on the top deck, that little where the control is up on top, and that covered. Yeah, I can. I've got it here, so I pulled it off to resew it. Okay. Well, I didn't figure you'd be going up there, so I pulled it off to resew it. I figured that's one thing I can do. So.
Model planes and the big planes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Actually, right now I'm working on North Island.
Okay, I'll come up there and take. I'll come down there and take a look. I
looked
at some
F-18s, but they put me on CH-53s
on your ship.
Oh wow.
Okay, all right. Which is okay. Well, I'll try to get down there this afternoon.
Because I was never military. I was in the airlines before, and then I used to work at Pratt and Whitney making
engines. Yes, sir. Thank you very much. Okay. Bye bye.
Then they closed down here.
Oh wow, that's pretty impressive. I have a friend that was an F-18 pilot. He actually just retired. He took me up in his he's got a little starts with a B. Bella
Blanca.
Yeah. Did a bunch of aerobatics.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
It was pretty intense. The top's over here, bud. That's impressive, though. That's really impressive. Can't even imagine what all goes into building an engine like that. Or a CH-53, you know?
Yeah, the 53s are crazy, because I was, like I said, I always worked on airplanes. These helicopters are just another world, and those things are... They're dirty and nasty.
Oh, I know.
They come
I know.
In, yeah. It's different, especially compared to the airline world, you know, where all the planes were...
Pristine,
nice and clean for the passengers. But I always tell Mitch, the best place to ever work, the best group of guys. I mean, anybody needs help, man, those guys are on it. No matter what, no matter who.
Wow, that's great. That's good stuff.
Yeah.
Hold your phone. He thinks this GPS is his phone. I've been letting him use it. It doesn't fit in there, but I guess it does.
I think we got all the seams.
We moved to Ocean Beach. The trailer park by the sea.
Say no more.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was just out there. What was I there for? Yeah, did you get a vehicle?
I did. That's my truck.
What is it? Chevy or Toyota?
Sierra, GMC.
Oh, good for you. Good for you. Good
yeah,
for you.
It's really nice.
Good for you. Carry more toys in there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I was out that area. And which job was that? Oh, there's some people have a house there. You know, was Pacific Beach Boulevard runs east-west, and it goes right out to, you know, the last street that runs north and south on the beach there.
Uh-huh.
And the water there, the water where you have... some land that comes out, and it's got the rowing club on it and all that, and there's a circular body of water like this, mm-hmm. and the rest of Mission Bay is here. And there's some houses there, but they're up off the water. But there's one area where they've got a footbridge, and the sand comes in like this. And there's houses right there on the sand. This
wow.
guy's got a house there.
Wow. Yeah, I know.
And the house is really something. So anyway, that's why I was out there. But my son lived out there for a while. But
yeah. Oh, I know. Oh, I know. Yeah, it's pretty crazy.
That's when he was younger and he was really fit and everything.
Yeah.
I told you. Yeah. Blonde, really cut and muscular, you know?
Uh-huh.
And one of the guys says, hey, Ty, would you like to work nights at the ladies' pub? And there's that girls' night out bar. It's something else now on right on Claremont Mason Boulevard.
Uh-huh.
So he's just waiting tables there at night. You can imagine what that does.
Yeah.
And then this other guy comes in and says, hey, Ty, would you like to consider working nights as a male stripper?
Yeah, you told me.
Some of the stories were something you can imagine.
Yeah.
when he told me when he lived in PB there, he'd be out or something, and the girls would be taking pictures of him. The girls he never even knew before.
Yeah. That's good shit.
Yeah, it kind of does things for your ego, you know what I mean?
Yeah. I'm in my second to last semester, Mitch.
Good for you. You want some coffee?
No, thank you.
There's water in there, too, if you want some water. Grab a couple. Look at the bottles of water there where the caps haven't been broken. Yeah, all any of those, look at it. You want one for your son, too?
No, we'll share.
Okay, all right. Let me throw a couple more in there while I'm at it.